Oke, okay, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Saya Muhammad Syabir bin Dasri. And today I would like to present about DC current and AC current. If you can see, this is for DC current for the first and for the first question, we given for two question. So this is our solution for the first question for DC current.
Thank you to Syabil bin Basri. Okay, for the circuit that's not given, we know that that have two loops, loop 1 and loop 2. Okay, for the loop 1, you know they have a 45 volt supply, 2 for resistor, 9 resistor, and 4 resistor. That loop, loop 1. And loop 2, the power supply is 50 volt, 12 for resistance, 9 for resistance, 3 for resistance. Okay, you have to find current I1 and I2. Okay, for the loop 1, negative 45. Why negative? Because in theory, if we start from power supply, the value output must become negative. Okay. Plus 2I1 plus 9I1 negative I2 plus 4I1. Okay, for the 2I1, okay, when the negative, so this must be positive, and then go to the here must be positive I1, and then out must be negative I2, then go through the 4 ohm is I1. So this must be the equation for the equation 1. It's, we start from 9. Why? Because we start from 9 because 9 is the in between in the loop 1 and loop 2. So it should be I2 negative I1 plus 12 I2 plus 15 both plus 3 I2. Okay. I2 must be positive, then out to 12, then positive to 15 volt, and then to 3 ohm must be positive. So the equation must be 0. Okay, then the equation for the equation 2, okay, solve the simultaneous equation, equation 1 and equation 2. Okay, so this is the equation 1 and equation 2. So this will be solved by using calculator, and then this is the answer for I1 and I2. I1 is 3.387 ampere, and for I2 is 0.645 ampere. Okay, that's all for me for the direct current.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Amir Aziz Benwar. Okay, I want to make a conclusion for the direct current. Okay, direct current use basic component is resistor only. Basic current, the basic component for direct current is only use resistor. Okay, direct current got two loop, clockwise and anti-clockwise. When we use clockwise, we must start the supply negative, and when we use anti-clockwise, we start from the supply positive. Okay. There are three methods of solving this loop. Whether we use simultaneous, second is elimination, and third is matrix. You can use any method that you want that is easy for you. That's all for me.
Okay, for the next question, we will continue with alternating current. As you can see, this is for our second question. You can see it's been given that you need to find the voltage and the current flow. I will continue this calculation to my friend Lukman.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Today I would like to continue
which is alternating current. Okay, from this diagram, we have given this resistor, two resistor which is 20 ohms and 8 ohms, and then given the capacitor 1 over 12 farad, and then the inductor which is 3H. Okay, the given is 50 cos 40 volt. Okay, we have to change this into the polar form, which is 50 designs equal to 0 because there is no angle in this equation. Okay, the equation is we have to find the V, which is voltage, and I, the current, from this diagram. Okay, first of all, this formula for inductor, which is ZL equal to J omega L. This formula, we have to find the Z, which is R, for the inductor, which is we have to substitute the omega, which is given 4, and then the L, which is the inductor, is 3H. And then J times 4 times 3, we get J 12 ohms. Okay, we continue to the capacitor. For the capacitor, we use this formula, which is 1 over J omega L. Okay, we have to substitute into this equation, which is 1 over J omega is given, which is 40, and then the L for capacitor is 1 over 12 farad, and then the answer is we got J 3 omega. Okay, then first of all, before we have to find the voltage and current, we have to find the Z equation, which is from this diagram we can see that the circuit in the series in the parallel circuit, but we have to solve this series circuit, these two series circuit, before we go to the parallel circuit. And then okay, for the series circuit, 20 ohm plus with 1 over 12 farad, which is like this. And then for this side, we have 8 ohm plus 3H, and then we make it 1 over the equation and 1 over the equation because it is in parallel. Okay, then we got 9 to 9 over 10634 minus 1383 over 21268i. Okay, we got this for Z equation, which is R. The voltage, which is equal to 49.99 less than negative 1.8395i. This is in rectangular form. If the equation asks in polar form, we have to change it by using calculator, by press shift, press number 2, press number 3, and then we got 49.99 less than negative 2.10797 degrees voltage. That's all. Thank you.
So my name is Mohd Faizwan, the Mohd Fauzi. Okay, so the coefficient for the alternating current, we can conclude that basically from alternating current, they have basic component, which is inductance and capacitor. So for alternating current, we use formula to get Z equation. Then after solve the formula, we have the in rectangular form. So if the question asks for polar form answer, we have to change by using calculator. So that's all the question for alternating.
Okay, this is a DC circuit. Okay, from this, the multisim, we got the result for the I1 here is 3.387 ampere, which and the I2, which is here, 6.45.16. There is two loop, one and loop 1 and loop 2. Okay. is the AC circuit, which is the voltage 50 cos 4T, and then we change to VRMS, we divided by set 2, we got 35.35. And then the reading of voltage here from multimeter 2, which is we got 35.34. And then the reading of current here from the multimeter, we got 2.423 ampere. Okay, that's all.